Hello, welcome to Laura's Painted Minis. I'm Laura, and today we have another of the Dungeons and Lasers terrain from the Elven Woods set. Sorry, I'm a bit late. I was trying to play around a little bit with lighting and background to see if I could make it a little bit less washed out, and then also as I was about to push the button to go live, I could hear the little toddler squealing, which is not what I shouldn't be hearing anything, because it's his nap time. So, beginning to think that staying late after my Bible study to let him play on the playground is not going to be a good idea. He just needs more time to kind of be at home and wind down. Before he's expected to take a nap. So this is just the highlight. I could definitely take these highlights higher, especially since I do tend to use the camera as a way to sort of double check my if I have enough contrast on the mini, which looking at it, I could definitely use more contrast. And there's some areas I'm just not really touching. I'm leaving kind of base coated / stippled, whatever. With terrain as big as this, I'm not gonna go in and make sure I get every single little detail. Tuesday I got my first started off the first video in a paint along series that I'm going to be doing on YouTube. I'd kind of been unofficially doing paint alongs to begin when I was first starting out, especially before I really got into Patreon videos and Twitch. But it wasn't like officially trying to do paint-alongs, because it just kind of get overwhelming to me at the time to have so many things out on my desk. Because I didn't have any extra shelves or anything. So if I started working on something, it was going to be on the desk until it was done. Which then also means the paints are going to be on the desk. At least for me. But this summer I was able to get a bunch of stuff to help with storage, free up some desk space, and have some shelves as well. So that's where I've got that many that I started. I got it up on one of the shelves, the new shelves. I decided to get started on the Claudia Vampire from the Solan Hall expansion and the Bones Kickstarter. Kind of went back and forth on whether or not that was going to be a good idea or not as the first, because I know there are people who still don't have it and who still don't have their order. But I do have like an idea of how to use her as part of that idea of doing a Dracula based one shot. Thinking of her actually as for Lucy Westera, I think is the character's name in the book. And, you know, even if people don't have their order now, they can either watch and enjoy and get ideas, get inspiration. Because I know sometimes that's just why people don't end up painting. They don't have ideas. They don't know what to do with a mini. Or it can be one of those things where for, in a few months when everyone's gotten their orders. They're searching around for ideas. That does mean I'm basically painting something from three different companies, I just realized. Because my many that I have that I'm painting up to sell on eBay is in Next Level Miniatures. Mini, this I'm painting right now, is from Dungeons and Lasers. And then the paint along mini is a Reaper mini. I'm kind of beginning to wonder if I'm gonna end up ever getting anything else from Next Level Miniatures, 'cause I mean, not be, and it's not because of the quality. Yes, they had some scaling issues the very first go, but they fixed that really quickly. So the very next Kickstarter, all of those issues were fixed. I have that, and I have that box still sitting. I haven't gone through it yet again recently to determine if there's things in that that I'll paint to sell. Got a couple trays on my pegboard labeled paint to sell, so I'll probably just wait till I've actually emptied those out before I do any more thinking about that with the other minis that I have. Some of the core set from the Reapers probably will maybe get into there. We'll see. Right now, it's going to be a lot of the volume one. Excuse me. It's going to be a lot of the Next Level Miniatures volume one stuff. They're from their first Kickstarter. Despite the big backlash, and I mean, I do agree they had some scaling issues. I did realize there were some inconsistencies. It was like technically, in most cases, a true 28 millimeter if you measure from the base to the very top of the mini. That's not a good way to measure miniatures, and they're really kind of wish there was kind of a standardized this is how you measure the scale of miniature. So if you measure that way, where it's the base to the top, very top of the mini, and you then compare that to a miniature. Same exact sculpt, but it was measured base, the base to the eyes. You think about it, the one that's been measured up to the eyes as a 32 millimeter scale, it's gonna look a lot bigger than the other mini that's been measured at the base to the very top of the mini. But I think they also were very, they wanted to use the SioCast machines, which is a very new technology / new machines still. They didn't already have them during the first Kickstarter, so I think there was, I kind of guess that had a lot to do with some of the scaling issues that they had. Especially considering they went and like immediately turned around with the second Kickstarter just fine. And I believe they're starting to get to the point where they can are actually releasing miniatures into their shop, their online shop, that aren't just miniatures from their Kickstarters. I could be wrong, I guess, since I don't have the more recent Kickstarters. Hey there, Big Harry. Yeah, universal scale would be really helpful. Especially for those people who are just gonna whine and gripe that it's not what they expected, even though it's a Kickstarter. Because there were a lot of those people in that first Kickstarter by Next Level Minis. And it was really annoying. Universal scale and a universal way of measuring. Because you can measure, technically, you can measure from the base to the top of the head, from the base to the top of the mini, or from the base to the eyes. Granted, like I already mentioned, if you do from the base to the top of the eyes, that's going to be what's going to give you a mini that will look the biggest comparatively. I'm having a pretty good Thursday so far. Still kind of dealing with some allergies, but not as bad. And it is my son's birthday today. So I'm going to try and do a little fun trip to a local bakery, let him pick out something. I usually stick to more like natural sweeteners and stuff, so it'll be a nice little treat for him. And then eventually he'll get to open some gifts once Dad is home. How was your Thursday going? I'm definitely excited to be getting to the to being done with this set of scattered terrain. It looks awesome. But it is a lot. But I know I need to knock it out because one, I want to actually be able to use it, and two, I'll have the caves Kickstarter coming within the next year. I forget when it's supposed to ship for just the regular shipping. I don't ever do the legacy just because they're fast in general and getting thing doing turnaround. So personally, I can wait a little bit of extra time and not be one of the first people to get theirs. I still have my swamp set to do too. And most of the stuff from that Kickstarter, the Encounters Kickstarter. I'm still kind of a ways from really being done with the Elven Wood set. I mean, all that's left is the grass and the moss on everything. But that's, you know, still have one more of these, this big one to do. And then there's three each of, one, two, three other sizes to do. All the rest are at least smaller than these big ones. And it is nice that there's varying sizes and they've got some different things. They've got some like ruins on some of the other. And a lot of, or like a lot of extra tree roots. Anyone else been catching or keeping up with the Agatha All Along series? I'm beginning to feel like I need to read up more on Mephisto because it I'm kind of wondering if they're dropping some big hints on that with the last episode, but I don't know very much about. That one, that character. Pretty funny though to think about it. Like, if you were GMing these sessions of each episode, there's so much railroading going on. I'm a big Marvel fan though, so I've really been enjoying all these extra shows they've been doing. I know they're not everyone's cup of tea. Not everyone, there's some people who are like, well, we need to go back to the old days, or like these aren't very good. I'm just I remember when the Daredevil movie that had Ben Affleck, like at that time, was decent for superhero movies. But if you actually went back and watched that, comparing it to the quality of superhero movies now, it just pales in comparison. So I feel like some people maybe are just a little spoiled with the MCU. I will say there's one movie in particular that I think was a step backwards as far as the quality they've been putting out, and that was Eternals, The Eternals. I feel like they were trying to try out too many new things. 'Cause they're trying to try out all these other lesser known superheroes. And I mean, Ant-Man was kind of the first test, I believe, to see if they can make that work with a lesser known character. But then I think they started going a little wild. Which I think they realize. I feel like maybe they realized that. I don't know. Maybe not. Maybe it just seems like it. They don't seem like they're going quite so crazy with all the different new ones building off of. They've introduced some new ones, new characters, and are building off of them. Yeah, I feel like. Okay, so I think this looks pretty good. Again, definitely could be some higher contrast. And there's also areas that I just am not like. There's technically kind of some rocks and stuff scattered in the mixture. And really, all I'm gonna end up doing. So, what I did on the other one, when I go in and actually build up the moss, I'll take those colors and actually just dab them ex in these areas that are especially littered with the rocks, just so that they have something more to them than a base coat. It's like over here too. I'm trying to think. So I've already got a start, like a base down for where I'm going to put, like as you can kind of see it. Like this side probably is best to show that of base. It's not really base coat. Stippling layer for the moss. And using these three colors. The gutter grime, so I just got that in the Kickstarter. Yeah. Which it has a two in the front, so that usually means it's a limited run. And yeah, I don't know if any of those colors are gonna get released. That'd be cool. I do really like this. It's a very nice olive green. Different from like the troll skin. And this works really well for building up the moss. At least with the greens that I do have. I don't have very many olive greens actually, so. Worked out well to get that. Probably won't get much of the moss, but I am gonna go ahead and show you. Mixing up the colors. So this color right here that I'm mixing, It's I put like 2 drops of gutter grime in here with the moss green. And this here is moss green with like a drop of Naga in it. So you can see how much that changed or how different that is, even though it's mo both mostly moss green. But it moss green, I will say, is really. I was doubtful at first when it was recommended to me that I should have it with my greens. But it has been really useful for creating a like a highlight for other greens. I'm gonna get out my good old stippling brush. Sure, don't dip it in the wrong color. And see, might have made that too thin. I kind of went on autopilot. I think I did 2 drops of water or something. But I'm gonna dab over, not completely, I still want that dark color to show, but then also kind of do a little bit around it too. And I'll do something similar with the highlight, only less. It'll just be kind of touches here and there, more towards the top of each kind of section or each group. And you're getting a little freebie today because this actually is also going to be this month's Patreon video. Only I'll be a little bit more, a lot more focused when I'm doing that. I might actually get some of that jungle moss. So jungle moss is that base dark color that I already got. I might come back with that a little bit just to make sure. It's a little bit on the yellow side, so yeah. Zoom out, see it. You already tell how much more that looks more like moss, but it definitely did get a little overdone on the yellowness. So I'm guessing on the that when I did the moss on the other one, I had a little bit of jungle moss mixed in with the gutter grime, so that it wasn't quite so yellow looking. So I'll have to go back and do some changes on that. That won't be too hard. That just means that this area is going to be extra mossy. So there we are. Will be trying to get the video done this week. I'm still kind of playing catch up from being sick last month, so. I also still have the PDF for last month's to do. But I do have it on my list to still get this month's video done and out on time. Then I'll work on the PDF from last month and get that out hopefully this week as well, so I can kind of be caught up. But yeah, if you like what you have been seeing so far and you want some more focused tutorials or even just PDFs, you can't afford very much. If you can afford $5 a month or something like that, you can get a PDF on the same topic as the videos each month. I think it's actually $4 a month is that lowest tier, and then $9.99 for the second tier will get you videos, access to videos and shout outs. And then that top tier has everything. Plus, I've got poll options in there somewhere if I start doing polls. Kind of need more patrons before I'll start doing any polls with that. But anyway, the top tier is at $15 a month and gets you a 25% discount on any commissions from me. And I am working on a detailed sort of a breakdown in how I would go about pricing things. It's not going to be, it might not necessarily be exactly the same for every person, just depends on what they're wanting. If they want to like something that's not quite the, if there's something that they want that doesn't quite fit in with any of the categories that I have on my pricing list, then I'm, you know, just have to talk it out and figure out. Which, if you just message me on any of the social media stuff that I'm on, that's a good way to get that started. And you can be looking on my Instagram and Facebook, as well as my Patreon for those, that price list, when I do get it done and posted. Anyway, with that, I'm going to go ahead and sign off, and I'll see y'all Monday back with the Orcus mini with this guy. I got the flames sculpted. So we'll probably work on that. All right. Have a good weekend, everybody, and I'll see you Monday. Bye.